I'm out in the prime cut of the Big Green. Behind me is Ed and Rowdy, members of an up-and-coming sub-adult gang. They're challenging everything, including me. Goes with the territory. If I show weakness, if I retreat, I may be hurt, I may be killed. I must hold my own if I'm going to stay within this land. For once there is weakness, they will exploit it, they will take me out, they will decapitate me, they will chop me into bits and pieces. I'm dead. But so far, I persevere. Persevere. Most times I'm a kind warrior out here. Most times I am gentle. I am like a flower. I'm like a fly on the wall, observing, non-committal, non-invasive in any way. Occasionally I am challenged, and in that case, the kind warrior must become a samurai, must become so formidable, so fearless of death, so strong that you will win. You will win. Even the bears will believe that you are more powerful. And in a sense, you must be more powerful if you are to survive in this land with the bear. No one knew that. No one ever friggin' knew that there are times when my life is on the precipice of death and that these bears can bite, they can kill. And if I am weak, I go down. I love them with all my heart. I will protect them. I will die for them. But I will not die at their claws and paws. I will fight. I will be strong. I'll be one of them. I will be the master. Still a kind warrior. Love you, Rowdy. Give it to me, baby. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Smell death all over my fingers.
All these majestic creatures were filmed by Timothy Treadwell, who lived among wild grizzlies for 13 summers. He went to remote areas of the Alaskan Peninsula, believing that he was needed there to protect these animals and educate the public. During his last 5 years out there, he took along a video camera and shot over 100 hours of footage. What Treadwell intended was to show these bears in their natural habitat. Having myself filmed in the wilderness of jungle, I found that beyond a wildlife film, in his material lay dormant a story of astonishing beauty and depth. I discovered a film of human ecstasies and darkest inner turmoil.
Hiding through.
As if there was a desire in him to leave the confinements of his humanness and bond with the bears, Treadwell reached out seeking a primordial encounter. But in doing so, he crossed an invisible borderline.
Go back and play.
This is what happens to them. They work together and they get really powerful. As you can see, I'm just feet away. You just relax. You just relax. He's now moving away from me. I've now proven myself as being able to hold my ground and therefore earning their respect. This is Rowdy the bear, and he's Rowdy. He's getting bigger. And, knew him from, he was little Dot a couple of years ago. He's getting to be a big boy. Anyway, we're doing just fine.
But that was a challenge, and you have to remain cool in the challenge, in the moment. If you don't, you're dead. They can kill. They can bite. They can decapitate. He was over 10 feet high, don't you? Ooh, he's a big bear. He's a big bear. A very big bear. Wow. Huh. Anyway, he's over here rub-a-dub-dubbing. He's a big bear.
Ooh. The excitement Treadwell felt connected him immediately with children. In his campaign to create awareness, he reached thousands and thousands of school children who would remember his fabulous storytelling as one of the highlights of their school years. He took his mission so seriously that he never solicited for a fee. Over time, he reached the status of a national celebrity.